Hey guys, I wanted to do a little video to compare myplate.gov, which I think the website's called choosemyplate.gov, which is the USDA dietary guidelines, their recommended foods versus healthy ketosis. Okay, just so you can kind of see the differences. So you can see roughly the 25% of the food should be fruit, 25% should be vegetable, and then you have the grains, which is between 40 and 60% of the plate. And then the protein would make up the difference, plus some dairy out here. So, and then healthy ketosis, you have vegetable, fat, protein with the carb outside the plate, okay? Because we want a very small amount. So with healthy ketosis, you're doing 7 to 10 cups of vegetables. Now with my plate, you're doing about 2 to 2.5 cups of vegetables. But you could do those vegetables in a vegetable juice, like in a V8. You can do canned vegetables, you can do iceberg lettuce, or you can do potato, a starch, okay? So that's acceptable. Over here, we want you to have leafy greens, and we want you to fill up the entire half of the plate. Now, what's interesting is that if you look at my pie chart here, vegetables account for 5% of the total calories. But if you look at the volume of vegetables, it takes up 50% of your plate, so it's this large amount of vegetables with very low amount of calories. So when you look at this chart and it says 5%, this appears to be not very significant, but when you look at the volume, it's actually pretty significant because it's going to fill up half the plate. Now, when we get into healthy ketosis with the fats, we want roughly about 70% of your total calories, okay? Now, in this chart, you can see it looks quite large, right? It's like more than 50%, but you have to realize that 1 gram of fat is more than double the calories, protein and carbohydrates. So the volume of fat is going to be a lot less because if you look at it here, like 70% looks like a huge amount, but in actual volume, it's going to be a lot less. And I think that's the confusion. People think it's this massive quantity of fat when in reality it's not. And of course, we keep the carbs down 5%. We want to keep those very small, between 20 and 50 grams per day, and our protein moderate, between 3 to 6 ounces per meal. The myplate.gov, they recommend low-fat, lean proteins. Over here, we recommend fattier proteins because we know that the leaner the protein is, the more it can spike insulin. And we're also not combining protein and sugar or protein and fat. So over here, we're combining protein with the grains, which if you combine these, you're going to really spike insulin because of this fact right here. So what they're recommending with the grains is at least half of those grains be whole grains. Now what that means is they're going to allow the other half to be refined grains. Why do they even let that in there? I have no idea, other than to fatten people up, because that's exactly what it's going to do. So they're recommending between 6 to 7 ounces of grains as a requirement every single day. It's just part of that meal. Now, let's take a look at this. 1 ounce would equal 1 slice of bread. So they're going to allow 7 slices of bread a day. Okay? A half a cup of cereal is 1 ounce. 1 pancake is 1 ounce. So they're going to allow 7 pancakes. You can have 7 pancakes a day. Let's see. We have 3 cups of popcorn. So you're allowed 21 cups of popcorn. Incredible. Or 1 small piece of cornbread. So we can do 7 small little slices of cornbread. Wow, that's an incredible diet, high in carbohydrates. And of course, they're also allowing the vegetable oils, the GMO, soy and corn and cottonseed oil and canola, which are all GMO, unfortunately. So I just wanted to create a quick video to give you a visual distinction on these two, to show you why this plate is 1,000 times healthier than this one over here. Thanks for watching. If you're enjoying this information and getting something out of it, please give me an unbiased Google review. I put a link down below. Thanks.